Beardo Benjo. Hello there, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Will It VR. Now, today I'm not going to be using Vorpex, I'm going to be doing something a little bit different. I'm going to be trying out a mod, and this mod is for Doom 3, specifically the BFG edition running on Steam. Now, this is a free mod called the Fully Possessed mod, and it basically completely overhauls Doom 3, which is the last Doom that was kind of a scary game, a lot more kind of slow-paced survival horror. Genuinely a pretty creepy game, not like the new bombastic, really good. I love the new Dooms, but not like the new Dooms in terms of kind of how fast-paced they were. It was a lot more like a survival horror game, a lot more like kind of a Dead Space-style romp, rather than a kind of a thoroughly action-orientated, jumping all over the place kind of game. So a very different game. But it overhauls the entire game into a fully-fledged VR experience, the kind of thing you could play standing up, because you can choose your scale, it tracks your arms, it tracks your head. It's meant to be absolutely fantastic, like a seriously impressive piece of VR modification, and I'm going to dive into it today. I don't know how good it's going to look. My capture was capturing two eyes, so I've had to blow one of the eyes up, so it's just capturing one eye, so it doesn't look too weird for the video. Hopefully that works, but we will see. I'm just going to dive straight in. I'm not going to show you which profile I'm using or anything like that. It's super easy to set up. You just need to install the modification into the directory where you've got the game installed. So mine's installed on my B drive. So I just installed the mod into the directory where the BFG edition of Doom is installed. And then there's an installer and you just run that and then that's it. You're good to go. You're good to play in VR. This is completely free, by the way. Blows my mind that these things exist and they're free. But it is. So let's rock and roll. I'm going to try not to punch anything off of my like side. If I come for you in the camera, I'm sorry. I'm going to try and play in quite a reserved, relaxing way. I'm just going to play one of the little maps that you can play. Play the first one. Yeah, I'm going to try and play in a relaxed way because I don't want to be punching my monitor or my camera or anything really. I don't want to punch anything. I just want to play and shoot some zombie men and have a good old time. Can't remember how far in it is until you get a gun.
Incoming transport detected.
Ooh! Ooh! Oh, there's me. Doom guy's come a long way. He doesn't look like that anymore, does he? Hey, look at this. Okay, so as I said, the mod is a full overhaul, so it fully tracks. Oh my God, look at my arm. Okay, if you spin the controller, you can break your arm. Oh my God. Oh, that arm's just already had its day, isn't it? Christ, can I get that one back to normal? There we go, that'll do. Yeah, so it's a fully fledged VR overhaul. It fully tracks your hands independently, which is really, really impressive. And obviously it tracks your head as well. And I've got it set to kind of like full locomotion, but I believe, you can use teleportation as well. So seriously impressive stuff for a mod. And again, this is completely free. I think you can pick up Doom 3 BFG edition.
All new arrivals need to check in at reception.
Shh. Stop. Stop talking. Shh, no more. You can pick up Doom 3 BFG edition super filthy cheap. I think I picked it up for a couple of quid. Just because I genuinely like Doom 3 BFG. I say it was the last kind of... Have you?
I'm getting off this rock.
I bet you're not. I bet you're gonna die. And I won't die because I'm the hero. Yeah, I picked it up because it was, you know, I genuinely like it. So it was a scary game. We'll get a bit of lag in, quite a lot of lag actually. Unsure why.
Okay,
you doing it?
Let me get this started.
I like that. If you look down, you can see your like health bar and stuff comes up. Oh, hello.
You're gonna need to hold still. Moving around only makes the test take longer.
Alright. I'm not exactly going anywhere, am I? It's a little bit smoother. Just feels a little bit laggy for some reason, but it looks really impressive, so.
For all
It's completely playable. It might be lagging just because I'm running OBS as well, and I run too many things when I do these videos. Oh, cutscene. I'm going to skip the cutscenes. I'm not going to worry about the cutscenes. Alright. I want to get a gun. How long does it take to get a gun? Let's go and get me a gun. I want to shoot stuff. Ooh. Remember the first time I played this, Doom? Look at that. I've got... So hench. Look at these hench arms. Look at that gun. Oh, my hand's gone through myself. That's fine, but look at that beautiful gun. That's like a chest burster. Can I get it? Put my hands inside my body. That's it. That's it. Put that in there. That's right. There we go. Oh! Why has he done that? Oh no, what's happened now? Oh, it's figured out. Look at that, you've got, you know, I'm impressed that I've actually got a, what's this called? A reflection, that's it. I'm impressed that I've got a reflection. So many games don't do that. And again, this is an older game. I remember playing it on my, like a piano. Ding, 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 ding. I remember playing it on the Xbox 360? No, was it original Xbox? I can't remember. It was either original Xbox or 360 when it came out. And it was well scary. I didn't expect it to be scary. I wanted like kind of just a crazy shoot some aliens, you know, Doom. But it was a creepy, scary game. Marine Command, that'll be where I need to go. Hello, sir. Okay. All right. Thank you. Appreciate it. In I go. Nah, you don't need another security team. It's weird to think that Doom, you know, Doom 2016 and Doom Eternal are so different from this, considering this is like the last Doom they made. They really did kind of reinvent the wheel and turn Doom into this super fast-paced, action-packed thing that it is now. And, you know, this I think, Doom 3 is closer to the original Dooms than the new Doom games are by quite a long shot. I mean, the original Dooms were great, but they were quite slow paced, and they were, you know, there was an element of tactics to it. You know, you couldn't just kind of run in. You needed to strafe around and pick your shots, and you still do in like Doom 2016 and Doom Eternal, but they're far more over the top, whereas this is a lot more like a survival horror game, and that's how I remember anyway, and I haven't played it in a very long time. Good thing about BFG editions, it comes with original Doom and Doom 2 as well, I think, and you can play them in VR, but they don't have like hand tracking or anything because they're super old, so they just run in VR, which is still cool to see. Go to sleep, little robot.
Welcome to the dungeon, Marine.
Oh,
most
thank you.
Exciting place on Mars.
Bit of my chest is kind of coming out.
I need you to grab some armor and secure your pistol before I can pass it through security.
Oh, I'll gladly take those things.
Okay, grab your gear.
Yes, thank you. Oh, nice.
Let me do a radio test.
Oh. Okay, so the torch is really cool. I remember this being a big part of the game because you have to have the torch out all the time, so kind of like you're going around and you're really scared because there were certain bits that were super dark. I can't get over how weird his arms are. Look, it pops back into place every now and then, but look at that! Just completely snapped in the middle. Alright, off I go. Oh. I won't get excited and shoot anyone unless they shoot me first. Okay, I've got a sprint with my trigger, which is cool. Hello. I've got crouch with the other trigger. Can I jump? I've got a jump button. Yeah, clicking my stick is jump. Clicking that stick turns my torch on. Really nice, intuitive controls. Like I say, I'm using my touch controllers. Because as I said a few times, this is a full VR overhaul. Shut up, you weird glasses-wearing freak. Don't tell me what to do. Go away. So my only gripe is I'm getting a little bit of lag, but I think that's more because I'm running OBS as well as this. I don't think it's a. It's not a slight on the modification of the game itself. I did do a little test run before I started recording, and it ran perfectly fine. So I think it's more that I'm just running a few things now. And when there's a lot of stuff going on like this, it's a little bit kind of overwhelming for it. Basically, it all goes wrong because it's Doom. It's abs. That's cool, look at that. You get the shadow of the gun. Oh no, look, hell has all broken loose. Skelly boy is gonna. Oh no, everyone's going into zombies. I think the Skelly boy turns this guy into a zombie and then I can shoot him. Yeah, look, instantly a zombie. Shut up. Okay, so the shooting is great. As I said, I did test this before. Hello. Oh, hello. I did test it before I... saving content. What's happening? Before I started recording. And the shooting is surprisingly good. I think it's because, again, you can move independently. Like, I can have that arm over there, and that there, or I can point that, just like, I've lost my torch. I've lost my pissing torch. What have I done? Torch is really important. Shit. I don't know what I've done with the torch. The torch is now, like, attached to wherever I'm looking. I feel like I've stuck it to my head or something. Oh, cool! Okay, I don't know how I did that, but I attached the torch to my head. This mod is very impressive, even if I don't know what I'm doing. Zombie, zombie. But all of that, his brain came out and he turned into a skeleton. Yeah, the shooting's really good. Again, for an older game, it's very impressive. That one, please. Again, I am not very technical. In terms of kind of installing mods and upgrades and that kind of stuff. And this is very easy to do. You literally just install the mod. No, don't close on me. Oh, let me out. Oh my god, please. Thank you. You literally just install the mod into what's happening. See what I mean? Scary Doom. What was that about? You install the mod into the same folder that, you know, the game is in. I didn't say that very well, but it's basically what you do. You just go to Steam, you find out where you've installed the game, and that's where you unzip the VR files. Just make sure you've run the game once first, and you've done a quick initial setup. I had a little bit of issue trying to get it to work because I hadn't set it up first. Thank you very much. The torch goes off every now and then. Oh no, look, zombies. Oh, look, it's a skeleton. Oh, hello. Can you die? Flipping hell. First you eat this man, and then you try and eat me. Greedy bastard. I want to get the shotgun. The shotgun's the best thing. Obviously, there's better guns in Doom, but the shotgun is so iconic. So fun to use. See, the torch goes off. Just every now and then, randomly. You could easily play this standing up. Whoa, alright. Does it really need to do that? Is it really necessary to come out of there swinging your bloody... Oh, see, look what happens. The door closes and now you're a skeleton. Yeah, really impressive mod. There's some great VR mods out there. And I say, I use Vorpex for a lot of what I do. But Vorpex would never be able to give you these kind of results where you can kind of independently move your arms and, you know, use them as if you were actually here. Vorpex doesn't do that. Vorpex isn't for that. And that's fine. Vorpex serves a very different purpose. Oh, shit. Thank you very much. Vorpex serves a very different purpose. I've said it a million times, but it's more about get out of here, you weird, whatever you are. It's more about experiencing and exploring games from a different perspective that you might have played a million times before. You know, see them up close and personal. This is a more in-depth and genuine VR experience. And if you're looking for that, then there are some fantastic mods out there for certain games. GTA 5, I've already covered that in one of my other videos. That was a mod, and that was very impressive. and Alien Isolation, a mod I haven't played, but it meant to be absolutely fantastic. Oh, where are you hiding? Cheeky little shit. Give me all that stuff you had. Oh no, hello. Hello there. Where have you gone? Oh, he's hiding. He's doing a hide. And you. Stop it. Both of you. Oh, what's he doing? I thought he was just going to come sprint. Oh, hello. Flaming heck. Click. What's happening?
Oh, thank you. I'm getting out of here.
Go on then. That was nice. I saved him. He didn't really thank me that much. He didn't seem to care. Yes, the shooting's really good. Get me armor. And you can do shit like that, you know? Can't do that in the normal game. Look to the side and walk this way. Shotgun. Yes. I've got that scary voice again. It's gone away. Oh, bloody hell. Oh, look at that, they explode. He didn't. Oh, he did now. Yeah, the shotgun is where it's at. Look at that. Absolutely fantastic. Scary down here. Alright. Getting back up stairs because it's scary down here. Up we climb. Thank you very much. Honestly, I urge you, if you've got a VR headset and you've got a couple of quid to spare, or maybe you own the game already, take that, you scumbag. Just grab a copy of Doom BFG Edition. Get the mod downloaded. Maybe load it up with HD texture packs and kind of other funky things that are going to make it even more impressive. And just dive right in because this is very fun. I'm not playing the full game right now. Oh, hello. This is like a proper army man. Oh no, you've got to reload. I don't know if there's a reload button. That's the only gripe I have. Go. Obliterated into a skeleton. Yeah, he's going to come out of there. Look, he's in there. Ain't coming out now. Oh, what have I done with my bloody torch again? Thank you. It's really cool you can put your torch up there on your head. Something I didn't expect it to be able to do is kind of interact with the character like that. Very, very cool. I don't know how I'm doing it, but I'm doing it. Definitely got a code red. It's all gone to shit. Oh, I've gone outside my own head. What's happening now? Oh, it's a cutscene of some description. Oh, there's a Doom monster. That was a little bit off-putting. Doom monster turned up there, and it pulled me out of my own face. Oh, that looks so good. Take that, you shit. Yeah, this is like next level great. Someone just sat and made this and said, you know what, I don't want any money for it. Just enjoy it, have some fun. Have some fun on me for free in these quarantine times. Oh, don't fire fireballs at me. That's it, fall down the stairs. Oh, hello. Jesus Christ. Don't you fucking dare. All your friends have died with one shot. Why did you take about 10? Hello, sir. There you go. That's what happens. Body bits there. Oh no, I've not reloaded my gun. Ah, shit. I wish someone would make a mod like this for the new Doom games. I've played Doom in VR using Vorpex, and it was very good. The 3D was great. It was a good experience, but I think there's just something really good about being able to move your arms around independently. Oh, look, there's a man there. Smash him to pieces. Okay, you can reload. It's the under trigger. I'm a nervous reloader. games.
What the fuck was that about?
I'm always reloading far too much. Well, I'm not very good at stuff like Call of Duty and Apex. Because I'm just always... I'll shoot one bullet and be like, well, I better reload. I've lost one bullet from the chamber, so it's definitely reloading time. Well, that was... Oh, well, unhelpful. All the things have fallen down. Beep. Beep, 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 beep. Monsters outside. Better get reloading, you know what I'm like. He appeared out of nowhere. Where am I going? This way? Where the monsters were? Back to security checkpoint. Ah! That's really, really good, this. Really, really good. Want that in there. Can't have it, though. Hello. You're a bit scary. Beep. And I've done it. Completed Doom. I didn't actually complete Doom. That was just the first level. And that's probably where I'll leave it. It's probably a good enough representation of what this is like. Hello. Yeah, really, really good. I'm going to leave it there. Honestly, check it out if you own the game and you have the ability and the capacity to do so. Oh, look at my goddamn arms. They've all gone a bit wrong. Look at that. That's just, you know, the height of why this mod is fantastic. Look at that arm. You could snap that in. With a toothpick, so easy to do, look how thin it is. Yeah, really, really impressive. Seriously, go and check it out. I'll put the links there to get all the bits you'd need to be up and running. And yeah, it's very, very good. It's a little bit of an older mod. I haven't had time to play it before, but a few people have recommended it to me, and it's very, very impressive. Honestly, go and check it out. If you've enjoyed the video, hit like, leave me a comment, and hit subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you very soon. Ooh, but it'll take me headset off, not to be rude. I'll see you very soon for another Will It VR. Take care of yourselves, guys. See you later.